Voices in the Wind Audio Theater presents Cinderella by Charles Perrault, adapted for audio by Diane Vandenhoven.
Once upon a time, in a land not too far away, there lived a young girl. Her father was an honored gentleman, wealthy and kind, and her mother was a woman of charm and grace. They lived in a grand house on a cobblestone street. For many years, the little family was very happy, until one day the mother grew ill. She called for her daughter to sit by her bed.
Oh, my dear child, stay as good and kind as you are now. Oh, and remember, when I am gone, I will keep watch over you.
With those words, the woman closed her eyes and took her last breath. Heartbroken, the young girl wept and wept, and would not leave the spot where her mother lay buried. Winter came and laid a blanket of the snow over her grave. And in the spring, when the sun had melted it off, her father remarried. His new wife was proud and haughty, and she brought with her two vain daughters. In time, the man fell ill and was laid to rest. In an instant, the young girl's life was changed, and she was banished to the kitchen below the stairs, where she toiled, all but forgotten. She made her bed by the fire and was always covered with the soot from cinders. So they called her Cinderella.
Is it six bells already? I just barely closed my eyes. You're right, Monsieur Pettypaws. It is far too early to be awake. But I do get to see the sunrise. Isn't it beautiful? Orange and purple and full of promise. The world opening just for us. I think it's going to be another beautiful day. What do you have to complain about? You get to lie in the sun all day. If only I could do that. One day I will. I will do as I please and not be ruled by the bells. But not today. Mm-mm. No food for us. Not until I clean the hearth and make the meals. A little song always makes things so much better. It will not always be like this. We just have to believe, and someday things will change. All right, all right. You may have one piece. And in return, you must promise to stay away from the mice. Now shoo! I have to hurry with my chores, or surely I will be... Oh, who can that be?
Good morning, my child. Spare a morsel of food for a hungry old woman.
Oh, I'm very sorry, but we have nothing.
No charity in a grand place like this?
All our money goes to the daughters of the house. They must keep up their appearances so that they may make good marriages.
Are you not a daughter of the house?
Only by half. It is through the kindness of my stepmother that I live here.
Oh, by the look of ye, her kindness is wanting.
That's her. I must hurry and attend to them.
One small bite is all I ask. Your kitchen garden is so well tended. Why, look, it is full of ripe vegetables. Oh, surely you can spare one.
Oh, it troubles me to see anyone go without food. Take a squash from the garden.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, Use the link in the video description.